Translation. Sanjaya said, having spoken thus, Arjuna, chastiser of enemies, told Krishna, Govinda, I shall not fight, and fell silent.
In the previous verse, Arjuna said that there is no profit in this fighting because the other side, they are all my relatives, kinsmen, and by killing them, even if I become victorious, so what is the value? That we have explained, that such kind of renouncement sometimes takes place in ignorance. Actually, it is not very much intelligently placed. So in this way, Eva-mukta saying this, that there is no profit in fighting, Eva-mukta saying this, Rishikesha, he is speaking to the master of the senses. And in previous verse he has said, Shishyaste aham prapanyam, I am your surrender disciple. So Krishna becomes guru and Arjuna becomes the disciple. Formally they are talking as friends. But friendly talking cannot decide any serious question. When there is some serious matter, it must be spoken between authorities. So, Rishikesham, I have several times explained, Rishik means the senses, and Isha means the master. Rishika Isha, they joined together, Rishikesha. Similarly, Arjuna also, Guruka Isha. Guruka means darkness, and Isha. Darkness means ignorance. Ajnana timirandhasya jnananyana salakaya chakshu mulitam jena tasmai sri guravino. Guru's duty is, a shishya, a disciple, comes to the guru for enlightenment. Everyone is born foolish. Everyone, even human being, because they are coming from the animal kingdom by evolution. So, the birth is the same, ignorance, like animal. Therefore, even though one is human being, he requires education. The animal cannot take education, but a human being can take education. Therefore, Shastra says, nāyaṁ deha, deha bhājāṁ niloki, kastān kāmān arhati vīru jānti. I have several times recited this verse. And now, in the lower than human being condition, we have to work very hard simply for four necessities of life: eating, sleeping, mating and defending. Sense gratification. Main objective is sense gratification. Therefore, everyone has to work very hard. But in the human form of life, Krishna gives us so much facilities, intelligence, we can make our standard of living very comfortable, but with the purpose of attaining perfection in Krishna consciousness. You live comfortably, that's all right, but don't live like animals, simply increasing sense gratification. The human effort is going on, how to live comfortably, but they want to live comfortably for sense gratification. That is the mistake of the modern civilization. Yuktahara viharasya yoga bhavati siddhi. In the Bhagavad Gita it is said, yuktahara. Yes, you must eat, you must sleep, you must satisfy your senses, you must arrange for defense as much as possible, not to divert attention too much. We have to eat yuktahara, that's a fact, but not utyahara. Rupa Goswami has advised in his Upadeshamrita, utyahara prayasascha prajalpa niyamagraha lulam janasangascha saravi bhakti pranasati. If you want to advance in spiritual consciousness, because that is the only objective of life, then you should not eat more utyahara or collect more. Utyahara prayasas prajalpa niyamagra. That is our philosophy. The other day in Paris, one press reporter came to me, socialist. So I informed him that our philosophy is that everything belongs to God. Krishna said, what is that? Bhoktaram jagatavasam sarvaloka maheswaram. I am the enjoyer, bhokta. Bhokta means enjoyer. So, bhoktaram jagatavasam. Just like this body is working, the body, whole body is working, everyone's, to enjoy life. But where from the enjoyment begins? The enjoyment begins from the stomach. You have to give sufficient nice food stuff to the stomach. If there is sufficient energy, if you can digest, if sufficient energy, then all other senses become strong, then you can enjoy senses. Otherwise, not possible. If you cannot digest, just like we have now, old man, we cannot digest. There is no question of sense enjoyment. So sense enjoyment begins from the stomach. The luxuriant growth of the tree begins from the root. If there is sufficient water, therefore, the trees are called padapa. They drink water from the legs, the roots, not from the heads. It's like wheat from the head. So there are different arrangements. As we can eat from the mouth, the trees can eat from their legs. But what must eat? Ahara nidra bhayamatun. The eating is there. Either you eat through your legs, or your mouth, or your hands. But so far Krishna is concerned, he can eat from anywhere. He can eat from hands, from legs, from eyes, from ears, anywhere. Because he is complete spiritual. There is no difference between his heads and legs and ears and eyes. That is stated in the Brahma Sanghita. Angani jasa sakalindriya vitti manti pashyanti pahanti kalayanti chiram jaganti ananda chinmaya sadu jala vigrahasya govindamadi purusham tamandriya. So, as in this body, our sense enjoyment should begin from the stomach. Similarly, as the tree begins developing luxuriantly from the root, similarly, Krishna is the origin of everything, janmadasya jataha, root. So, without Krishna consciousness, without pleasing Krishna, you cannot be happy. This is the system. Therefore, how Krishna will be pleased? Krishna will be pleased that we are all Krishna's son, God's son. Everything Krishna's prophet. These are facts. Now, we can enjoy taking prasadam of Krishna because he is the proprietor, bhukta, enjoyer. So everything should be given first to Krishna and then you take the prasad. That will make you happy. That is stated in the Bhagavad Gita. Bhunyante te abham papam je pachanti atmakaranat. Those who are cooking for eating themselves, they are simply eating sins. Bhunyante te abham papam je pachanti jagyarthe karmanatra lokayam karam. Everything should be done for Krishna. Even if you are eating anything. All sense enjoyment. You can enjoy, but after Krishna has enjoyed, then you can. Therefore, Krishna's name is Rishikesha. He is the master. Master of the senses. You cannot enjoy your senses independently. Just like the servant. Servant cannot enjoy. That is a cook, cooking very, very nice food stuff in the kitchen, but he cannot eat in the beginning. That is not possible. Then he will be dismissed. The master first of all must take, and then they can eat all the nice food stuff. So, Krishna is the master of the senses. The whole world is struggling for sense gratification. Here is the simple philosophic truth that first of all let enjoy, let Krishna enjoy. He is the master. And then you enjoy. Tena taktena bhunjita. Everything belongs to Krishna. Ishavasam midam sarvam. Everything belongs to Krishna. This is the mistake. Everything belongs to Krishna, but we are thinking everything belongs to me. This is illusion. Aham mameti. Aham mameti. Janasya mohoyam. Aham mameti. This is illusion. Everyone is thinking, I am this body and everything, whatever we find in this world, that is to be enjoyed by me. This is the mistake of civilization. The knowledge is, everything belongs to God. I can take only whatever He gives me kindly, a lot. Tena taktena punjita. This is not Vaishnava philosophy. This is the fact. Nobody is proprietor. Ishavasamidam sarvam. Every Krishna says, I am in charge. I am the proprietor. Sarvaloka maheswaram. Mahayasam. Maha means great. We can claim Ishvara, controller. But Krishna is described as Mahayasam, controller of the controller. That is Krishna. Nobody is independently controller. So, therefore Krishna is described Rishikesha, Rishikina Rishikesha Sevanam Bhakti Ruchyate. And bhakti means to serve Rishikesh, by the Rishik. Rishik means senses. Krishna is the master of the senses, and therefore whatever senses I have got, that master is Krishna, proprietor is Krishna. So when our senses are engaged in the satisfaction of the master of the senses, that is called bhakti. This is the definition of bhakti, devotional side. And when the senses are engaged for sense gratification, not for the master, that is called kama. Kama and prema. Prema means to love Krishna and do everything for satisfaction of Krishna. That is prema, love. And kama means everything done for the satisfaction of my senses. This is the difference. The sense is the medium. Either you do it, satisfy your senses, or you satisfy Krishna's senses. But when you satisfy Krishna's senses, you become perfect. And when you satisfy your senses, you become imperfect, illusion. Because you cannot satisfy your senses. That is not possible without Krishna. Rishikena Rishikesha Sevanam Bhakti Ruchyate. Therefore, one has to purify the senses. At the present moment, everyone is trying to satisfy his senses. Aham mameti janasya mohoyam pumshang sriyami thuni bhavameta. The whole material world is that there are two living entities, male and female. The male is trying also to satisfy his senses, and the female is also trying to satisfy her senses. Here the so-called love means there is no love. It cannot be love. Because the man and woman, nobody is trying to satisfy the other party's senses. Everyone is trying to satisfy his or her senses. A woman is loving a man for satisfying her senses, and the man is loving a woman for satisfying. Therefore, as soon as there is some little disturbance in the sense gratification, divorce. I don't want it. Because the central point is personal sense gratification. But we can make a picture, so what? Oh, I love you so much, I love you so much. There is no love, it is all kama, lust. In the material world, there cannot be possibility of love, it is not possible. The so-called cheating. Cheating only. I love you. I love you because you are beautiful, it will satisfy my senses. Because you are young, it will satisfy my senses. This is the word, material world means this. Pumshang sriya mithuni bhava metha. The whole basic principle of this material world is sense gratification. Janamaithunadi grihamedi sukham mithucham. Kanduyanena karayo livadukha dukham. This material world, so-called love, society, friendship, love, everything is depending on that sense gratification. Maithunadi. Beginning from sex, janamaithunadi grihamili sukham mitucham. So, when one becomes free From this Maithunadi Sukham, he is liberated. He is liberated. Swami, Goswami. So now one is attached to this Maithunadi sex impulse. He is neither Swami nor Goswami. Swami means when one becomes master of the senses. As Krishna is the master of senses, so when one becomes Krishna conscious, he becomes master of the senses. It is not that senses should be stopped. No, it should be controlled. When I require, I shall use it, otherwise not. That is master of senses. I shall not act impelled by the senses. Senses should act under my direction. There is Sun. Therefore, Arjuna is called Guru Krishna. He is master. He is also, when he likes, he is not a coward, but he is compassionate because he is devotee. Because he is devotee of Krishna, anyone who becomes a devotee of Krishna, all the good qualities manifest in his body. Jashasti bhakti bhagavati akinchana sarvai gunai tatra samasati sura. All godly qualities. So, Arjuna is also, otherwise how he can become intimate friend of Krishna unless of the same position? Friendship becomes very strong when both the friends on equal level, same age, same education, same prestige, same beauty, the more similarity of position, then the friendship is there, strong. So Arjuna is also on the same level of Krishna, just like if somebody becomes a friend of the president, friend of the king or queen. He is not ordinary man. He must be of the same position. Just like the Goswamis. The Goswamis, when they give up their family life, it is described by Srinivasa Acharya. Taktya churnamasi samandalapati sanin sada tuch. Mandalapati, big leaders, mandalapati, big leaders, jamindars, big man, who has minister, who can become his friend, unless he is also a very big man. So Rupa Goswami gave up their company. As soon as Rupa Goswami and Sanatana Goswami became acquainted, we see Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Immediately they decided that we shall retire from this ministership and join Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu to help him, to serve him, not to help him. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu doesn't require any answer. But if we try to associate and try to serve him, then our life becomes successful. Just like Krishna says, Krishna came to preach Bhagavad Gita. Sarvadhanman parityajamamekam sam. That was his mission. That these rascals have become a servant of so many things. Society, friendship, love, religion, these, that, so many things. Nationality, community. So these rascals should stop all this nonsense business. Sarvadhanman parityajamamekam. Give up all this nonsense. Simply just become surrendered to me. This is religion. Otherwise, how Krishna is advising that sarva-dharmān parityajya? You give up all religious system. He came dharma-samasthāpunārthāya. He came to re-establish the principles of religion. Now he says, sarva-dharmān parityajya. Give up all. That means anything without Krishna consciousness, without God consciousness, they are all cheating religion. They are not religion. Religion means dharmantu sāsāt bhagavat pranītam. The order of the Supreme Lord. If you do not know who is the Supreme Lord, if you do not know what is the order of the Supreme Lord, then where is religion? That is not religion. That may go on in the name of religion, but there is cheating. So, the Bhagavad Gita ends sarva dharman parityajya mamekam saranam bhaja. And Bhagavad begins from that point. Therefore, Bhagavad Gita is the preliminary study of Srimad Bhagavad. Bhagavad begins dharma prajita koitavatra. Now, in this Srimad Bhagavatam, all cheating type of religions are rejected. Prajita. So there is link. Real religion means love God. That is real religion. Therefore, Bhagavad says, sabai pumsam parvo dharma, jato bhakti radho khaje. That is first-class religion. It doesn't mean that you follow this religion or that religion. You may follow any religion, it doesn't matter. Either Hindu religion or Christian religion or Mohammedan religion, anything you like. But we have to test, just like a student who has passed any examination. Nobody inquires from which college you have passed your examination. You have passed M examination, that's all right. Then we are concerned whether you are graduate, postgraduate, that's all. Nobody inquires from which college, from which country, from which religion you have passed your M examination. No. Similarly, nobody should inquire to which religion you belong. One must see whether he has learned this art, how to love God. That's all. That is religious. Because here is the religion. Sarva dharman parityajya mamekam saranam. This is religion. Bhagavad said, dharma prajita koitavatra, all not cheating type of religion, is kicked out from this Bhagavatam. Only nirmasarana. Nirmasarana, those who are not envious of God. Why shall I love God? Why shall I worship God? Why shall I accept God? They are all demons. For them only, Srimad Bhagavatam. For them, those who are actually serious to love. Ahituki apatyatha jinatma samprasidati. So, real success of life is that when you learned how to love God, then your heart will be satisfied. Janglam dha chaparang lamang mannate inadikam tata. If you get Krishna or God, Krishna means God. If you have got another name of God, that is also accepted. But God, the Supreme Lord, the Supreme Person, when you have got this, because we are loving somebody. The loving propensity is there in everyone. But it is misdirected. Therefore, Krishna says, kick out all these loving objects. Try to love me. Sarva dharman parityajya mamekam. In this way, your loving will never be able to satisfy you. Jinatma samprasidat. If you want real satisfaction, then you must love Krishna or God. That is the whole philosophy, Vedic philosophy. Any philosophy you take. Because after all, you want satisfaction of yourself, full satisfaction of your mind. That can you only achieve when you love God. Therefore, that religion is first class, which teaches, which trains the candidate how to love God. That is first class. Savai pumsang paro dharmo jato bhakti. And that love now is the motive. Just like here in this material world, I love you, love me. The background is some motive. Ahituki, apratita, ahituki. No motive. Annavilasita, sunlam. All other desires making zero. Zero. That will be taught in the Bhagavad Gita. Annavilasita, sunlam. Jnana karma anabritam. People are working, somebody is working for knowledge and somebody is working for sense gratification. This is the material world. This is the material. Somebody is trying to become very big scholar. Knowledge. What is this? What is this? What is this? Not for understanding God, but for having some superfluous knowledge. So this is called jnana. And karma means working day and night for sense gratification. So bhakti is transcendental. Annavilasita sunnam jnana karmad anabritam. Not tainted by all these contamination. Jnana and karma. Therefore Narottamdas Thakur says, jnana kanda karma kanda sakali bishere bhando. Either you are engaged in the activities of karma or either you are engaged in the activities of speculative knowledge or acquiring knowledge. So this is jnana-kanda and karma-kanda. So Narottamdas Thakur says that both these jnana-kanda and karma-kanda are pots of poison. Either you drink this or that. It doesn't matter. Being engaged in karma kanda, jnana kanda is spoiling his life. What benefit you will derive? Karma kanda, according to karma, you will get a different body. Jnana kanda also, if you actually become very much advanced in knowledge, you can get a body in a brahmana family, in a very educated family. But I will have to go through the transmigration of the soul, repetition of birth and death. There is risk. I do not know what I am going to get. It is no guarantee. Little mistake, just like Bharat Maharaj. Little mistake. At the time of you are thinking of a deer, next life you got the life of a deer. Little mistake. Because nature is so perfect, at the time of your death, what is the mental condition, you will get a similar body. Next life. Karmana daimanatrena. Because daiva, Krishna is with you. Krishna will see, now he is thinking of becoming a king. Now he is thinking to become a dog. So Krishna immediately gives you. You take the body of a dog, you take the body of a lion, you take the body of a king, take the body. Similarly, if you are thinking of Krishna, take the body of a Krishna immediately. Takta deham punarjanma naiti, mameti kauntiya. This is Krishna consciousness. How to train the mind to die thinking of Krishna, then your life is successful. Therefore you have to chant Hare Krishna, always think of Krishna. Manmana bhava madhyakta madhyaji mahanamaskuru. Then your life is perfect. Thank you very much.